Hello, and welcome to this tutorial for BioXTAS RAW. In this tutorial, you will learn how to align bead models or electron density models generated from SAXS data with high-resolution structures from crystallography, EM, or NMR. It is often important to align SAXS reconstructions, either bead models, such as those from DAMIF or DAMIN, or electron density from DENSE, with high-resolution structural models such as those from X-ray crystallography to see how well they agree. RAW can do that automatically when you generate the models, and this has been described in previous tutorials. RAW also provides standalone windows for doing the alignment with already generated reconstructions. This tutorial is in two parts. First, we're going to discuss aligning bead models to high-resolution structures using soupcomb from the ATSAS package. This requires a separate installation of ATSAS. If you haven't already done that, you should do so now. To start with, we need to open the window for soupcomb. We're going to go to the Tools menu, ATSAS, and in the submenu that pops up, we're going to select soupcomb. This opens a new window. There are two main things we have to specify here, the reference file and the target file, both of which should be PDB files. In this case, the reference file refers to the model to which we're aligning, and the target file is the model being aligned. To put it another way, the reference model stays unchanged, while the target model is moved to best align with the reference. So what we're going to do is we're going to select the reference model. In this case, I'm going to use a glucose isomerase crystal structure and the data that we've previously generated for that. So I'm going to click select, and then in the raw tutorial data, in the reconstruction data folder, GI complete, and select this file, this 1XIB, which is the crystal structure for glucose isomerase. I'm then going to select a target file, which is the bead model. So here, reconstruction data, we can either use the DAMIF reconstructions we've already generated. If you haven't generated those yet, you can go to the GI complete folder and use the DAMIF data in there. So I'm going to go up a level. I'm going to use the data we generated in a previous tutorial. I'm going to scroll down until I find the refined file. I'm going to select refine glucose isomerase-1.pdb and click open. You can also adjust some advanced settings here, modes, the way it's calculating the similarity, things like that. Once we have both models selected, we click Start. If you're not sure that you've selected the right model, since it's just showing the file name, if you hover your mouse over the file name, it'll give you the full path to the model that you've selected, and so you can verify you've selected what you meant to select. I'm going to go ahead and click Start. It's telling me that there's already a file with the same name as what the output aligned file will be. That's because we did the alignment automatically when we generated the models. In this case, I'm going to say yes, let's overwrite it. We'll redo the alignment. You can see the alignment status prints out here. When it's done, it'll say it's finished. Before I finish with this bit of the tutorial, I want to note that soupcomb is not natively implemented in RAW, and if you use it, you should cite the appropriate paper to cite the program from the ATSAS package. To learn what that is, click on the How to Cite button, and the paper is given there. Once we're done with the alignment, click OK. Now, this will create a dash aligned model in the folder that we chose. So if we go to reconstruction data, go to GI DAMIF, and we scroll down, we can see that there's a refined glucose isomerase-1 aligned.pdb file. This was generated today, just a couple minutes ago, if you look at the time, or less than a couple minutes ago. And this is the new alignment file that we just generated. For the second part of the tutorial, we're going to discuss how to align electron density files that are generated through DENSE to high-resolution structures. This can be done when you initially do the reconstructions. It can also be done through a separate window in RAW. So to open the electron density alignment window, we're going to go to Tools, Electron Density, Dense, Alignment. Here we see essentially the same window as the soupcomb window. We have the reference file and the target file. Again, the reference file is the file to which we want to align, and the target is the file to be aligned, which is to say the reference file is unchanged and the target file will be rotated and moved to match the reference file. What we're going to do here is we're going to use the same data set for the references before. So I'm going to select reconstruction data, GI complete, and this crystal structure. For the target file, I want to select NMRC, which is the electron density generated through dents. I'm going to use the dense data that we generated in a previous tutorial. If you haven't done that tutorial, the data is available in the GI complete folder as well. So here you can see all the dense reconstructions. I'm going to use the refined reconstruction. So in this case, we want the glucose isomerase refine.mrc. I'm going to click open. You can also adjust some advanced settings here. Once we're ready and all the settings are set, I'm going to click Start. Because we did the alignment for dents when we generated the reconstructions, we're getting a warning that the output file already exists. That's okay, I'm going to just replace it for the purposes of this tutorial. So you can see here it's printing the status, and we'll wait for it to finish. While we're waiting for it to finish, I want to mention that dents was initially developed outside of RAW, and so if you use dents, you should make sure to cite the appropriate paper given here in how to cite. This can take a little while to run, so we'll resume the tutorial once it's finished running. So now that dents is finished running, we can see the output of the alignment. We can click OK. And if we open a file browser, we can go to the appropriate folder, and if I scroll down, you can see that there is a glucose isomerase refined aligned produced today, just about a minute ago. The other thing I want to mention is that by default, the dense alignment will center the PDB file on the origin. So if you go into the GI complete folder, you can see that there's now this one XIB former centered file. This is what you'd want to open up in your molecular viewer of choice to check the alignment of the electron density. With that, that's the end of this tutorial. You should now know how to use RAW to align three-dimensional reconstructions from SAXS data with high-resolution models.